importance does song carry in the Christian life, and why should we still sing to God and sing to each other? This is a question that's been in my heart lately, as I've been reawakened to the value of worship through song. And this is something I had put on the shelf for a while, because I'm like, I came from this paradigm of I sing to God to experience His presence. But when I started to experience His presence beyond the place of a song, I discarded that as something that wasn't necessary anymore. And I'd seen how so many times I had encountered God in the song, yet my theology was off. And I encountered God because I had the right heart and the right intent, not because I had the perfect theology. And so anyways, I've just had this paradigm shift on music and the importance of it, because I started to see a broader aspect of worship beyond singing. But then I went too far with it, got out of balance. I'm like, well, then it's not important, or it's not necessary. And that's kind of odd in itself, considering I'm a very creative and a very musical person. But you know what started to stir in my heart is, how would Jesus sing to the Father? Because we're not meant to sing all these defeated songs. And man, the other day I listened to some of the most popular Christian songs, or most played list, and it was pathetic, honestly. I don't say that to be hurtful, but it really was. And I was like, God, I want songs that are victorious. I don't want songs that bring me down. I want songs that help me walk more like Jesus and have His life live through me. So I looked on this topic. I was like, well, would Jesus sing praise to the Father? And I found two verses, one in Hebrews and one in Romans, where it's quoting the Psalms. And it says, Jesus said this, is, I will proclaim your name to my brethren. In the midst of the congregation, I will sing your praise. That's Hebrews 2:12, quoting the Psalms, talking about Jesus saying that. And then Romans 15:9, also quoting the Psalms, saying, for the Gentiles will glorify God for His mercy, as it is written, therefore I will give praise to you among the Gentiles. I will sing to your name. So there's obviously still a place where Jesus sings to the Father. But it's something connected to what He did for us. And if we could learn how to sing to the Father like Jesus sings to the Father, we make our praise in Him and through Him, rather than just to Him and for Him, I believe that's going to open up a whole new world. That's a whole new flood of songs right there out of that place. I'm not saying it's wrong to sing to God, I'm saying you still should, but there's a place where God actually sings through you, and you are in God, and you're singing to Him. Like, you're in Jesus's shoes. But that's a whole nother thing to unpack right there. And so I was looking up, you know, what other verses in the scripture talk about singing to God? New covenant, sonship verses. And I found one in Ephesians 5:18-19. It says, do not get drunk with wine, for that is dissipation, but be filled with the Spirit, speaking to one another in psalms and hymns and in spiritual songs, singing and making melody with your heart to the Lord. And I started to look up some of those words, like psalms or hymns, and because we just throw these words out here, but what do they actually mean? And the word hymn was like singing an ode or a song of victory to a god, because it was used before Christianity. So in Greek mythology, they had several gods. So they would sing songs of how this god conquered. So Paul's using this word because he knew that they would understand what it meant. Said, guys, when you sing hymns, you glorify God for what he did, the victory that he wrought in Jesus. And I know when I start hearing those cross and resurrection songs, man, something just sparks within me because it gets me focused on the big picture instead of all the little details. And it's like problems that seem big become little in the eyes of resurrection. And I noticed that it also said that you're supposed to speak to one another and make melody in your heart or with your heart to the Lord. So it goes both ways, where you're not just worshiping God when you sing, but you're encouraging one another. And that connects with that body ministry that you are not an island, that you are connected to the rest of the body. And the body is connected to the head, which is Jesus. And it's another verse about singing praise to God is from Acts 16, verses 25 through 26. And it says, at midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns of praise to God, and the prisoners were listening to them. And suddenly there came about a great earthquake, and the foundations of the prison house were shaken. And immediately all the doors opened, and everyone's chains were unleashed. The beauty I find in that is they got their eyes off of their situation and onto Jesus, and how they did that was singing. It wasn't just speaking. Yes, there's a glory in speaking. There's a flow of God when you speak the word in accuracy and truth. But there is also a value when you sing God's word. And even physically, what singing does to your brain, man, it makes you feel better, period. But this was more than just a feeling better. This was a supernatural result that came out of it that didn't just set them free, it set everybody free. So that's big. And I know there's been so many times I've gotten healed in worship because I wasn't focusing on the problem. I was just letting Jesus flow out of me. And when I worshiped, it helped me submit myself to the Lord. And that's one way of doing it. So don't just discard the song part of it because you've submitted yourself to God through other ways of doing it. See it as an extension. See it as a that is valuable too. It's not an either or, it's yes, both. Because God can manifest himself through speaking and preaching the word accurately, but God also manifests himself through you singing his word accurately. In both ways will set people free. And as a result, he even says in Ephesians, that's a command. And it explains, here's how you get filled with the Spirit constantly, just doing this all the time. Let it be flowing out of you. And I know another aspect of song physically is it helps you to remember things. I remember one person had said, I believe it was A.W. Tozer, that people forget a sermon, but they'll remember a song. Because a song has a rhythm to it, and it has a repetition to it, and it sticks with you. So that's why it's important to have truth in song rather than lies in songs. And I know that, actually, I think it was A.W. Tozer too, that had said, Christians don't tell lies, they sing them. Which is really kind of a cynical attitude, but I see how it's been true, sadly enough. And but you know what? I just declare that the body of Christ is getting revelation on, and how does God want them to sing, and how does this fit together with the big picture? Because it's not just pretty sounds, but it's spirit and life released. And I know, like, even myself, like how I started out worshiping and song is I did not focus on sounding pretty. That started to develop later on, but that wasn't my main focus. My main focus was I just want my heart right with God and fixing my focus. In other words, not just letting my mind wander wherever it will, but nope, I'm going to focus on this aspect of God's character, his nature, what he has done, and sing out of that place. That's all I have for today, and I hope to hear some of you guys' input on this. What's been stirring in you? What's some of the revelation that you've seen out of the New Covenant perspective of song in God?